Have you got a race that is fast approaching? Are you starting to feel the nerves building ahead of that open water swim?
Yeah, it's entirely normal, but do not panic. Now is the time to prepare. So we have got all of the points covered that you need to consider ahead of your first race, included in this video. So take a look, and then you can work out what you need to focus on over the next few weeks.
Right, before we actually start on the swimming part, let's talk about the kit, because this can significantly impact our swimming performance. Let's take goggles, for example. Now, obviously, these need to be comfortable and not leak. That's pretty fundamental basics of a goggle. But also, you need to consider the conditions that you're going to be swimming in with goggles. For instance, let's take here, very sunny right now. A mirrored set of goggles is ideal because it's going to stop that glare off the surface of the water, but say it was in duller conditions, you're going to want something that is going to allow as much light in as possible or even enhance the light. And talking of conditions, if it's quite cold, you're probably going to want one of these, a wetsuit. And if it's super cold, you may even want to go to the extent of having two silicone swim caps, maybe even a neoprene swim cap on underneath, or neoprene booties or gloves should the race allow. But on the opposite end of the spectrum, if it's really hot, these may not even be allowed altogether. So you need to be used to swimming in just a tri-suit alone, or perhaps even opting for a swim skin.
Well, sticking with the wetsuit, there's a few tips around how to wear it, how to put it on, and how to get it off. So first up, using the plastic bag trick. Simply put a plastic bag over your foot and it's going to enable you to put your wetsuit on and just get it over the ankle that much more easily. And once you're at that stage, you then need to obviously make sure you've got it on properly, pulled up into the arms, pulled up into the crotch adequately, because once you start swimming and it gets wet, you're not gonna be able to move it. So it's worth spending a bit of time making sure it's fitting correctly. And once you've got your wetsuit on securely, then it's a good idea to actually use some lubrication around your wrists and your ankles, because this is going to help you remove it when you get into T1. Just having that area a little bit more slippery, it's going to slide off super easy. And whilst we're on the topic of lube, make sure you do cover any areas that might chafe, like around the back of your neck. And finally, talking of getting your wetsuit off quickly, ask someone who likes to swim wearing a watch, make sure you put it under your wetsuit. I've made that mistake, luckily only in training before, but putting it over my wetsuit, trying to get your wetsuit off, and you get completely stuck. And then once you are ready to head to the start, just get a friend to secure your zip and ideally tuck in that loose end just to save it getting caught by any fellow swimmers, as it could potentially start to undo.
Well, now let's move on to our pre-race strategy. And a good idea for this is to work backwards from the event. And I want to start by talking about nutrition. Now, I normally recommend that you have your last big or main meal around 2.5 to 3 hours before the event. That just allows your body time to digest the food rather than you having a big meal sat heavy in your stomach. And also with that allows you some of those necessary lube breaks that you're probably going to need before the race start. And then going on from that, you're probably going to want to take with you something small like a gel or a cereal bar, some simple sugars just to top up those carb levels as you get closer to the race.
Yeah, and then you want to think about the warm-up itself. You need to find out whether you're even allowed a warm-up, and if you are, what you want to do with that. Sometimes you might not even want to get in the water if it's super cold, because you're going to get too cold from that, and you'll have to rely purely on a dry land warm-up. If that is the case, then make sure you do something that's going to get your heart rate up, your blood flowing, and just your arms and your shoulders moving and feeling flexible so they are ready to swim. And you'll find that most events will let you jump in the water for a short period beforehand, and you need to use that time wisely. So acclimatise, get used to the water temperature, do a few fast strokes just to kind of get the feel, and also make sure you find the correct position. And if it's an in-water start, well, you'll be getting in the water anyway, so try to make the most of that short time you have.
Well, actually, the positioning probably requires its own section or video in itself, because it is such a big topic, but it really does require some thought prior to the race. So as soon as you know what the swim course is, give some thought to where you should position yourself. And this is going to change from swimmer to swimmer. If you're a confident swimmer, then you could perhaps go for the fastest or the shortest line to that first buoy. But if you're less confident, you may actually want to go further out away from the masses. It may mean that you have to swim further, but you're going to be more relaxed and probably ultimately swim better.
Yeah, and beyond choosing that line, you want to think about feet. Yeah, I'm talking about the feet of your fellow swimmers and whether there's any you can take advantage of. Yeah, I'm talking about drafting here. If you can find some feet to get on, you can save as much as 30%. So I would say it's worth that little bit of effort of maybe chatting to people, find out if they're a similar pace, or even once you start, just putting that surge in to get on some feet. And finally, it goes without saying that you need to know the course, but spending a bit of extra time studying it closely, knowing what colour the buoys are, and then looking at the land and seeing if you can actually line up the buoys with a landmark. Because once you're in at water level and you're in amongst with the adrenaline and in a race setting, it can be quite actually hard to see the buoys, even if from land they look really obvious. And if instead you've got a tower block or a tree or something, you can sight off that, you'll find it much easier.
Well as trying to find some feet to draft off and some landmarks to sight, there's some other tips that we can take on for the swim that can help us further. And one of which is kind of going with an open mindset and being prepared to be flexible. And what I mean by that is that the open water is a changing environment. It's not like simply swimming in a swimming pool. For example, you might be swimming along and a wave starts crashing and hitting you from one side. You may then want to adapt your stroke so that you're breathing away from the waves to stop you swallowing any water. Talking of waves, you may even want to sight waves as you're swimming so that you dive through them rather than battling against them. You may even want to use them to your advantage as you're coming back into the shore and kind of body surf them to a degree. There's also currents, less of a factor in most swims, but if there is a strong current, you may want to avoid that to prevent you from hemorrhaging any time. Also, again, you can use that to your advantage as you're coming back in.
Yeah, and talking of coming back in, as you do start to approach the finish, there's a couple of things you want to think about. Firstly, try to increase your leg kick a little bit, as this is just going to get the blood flowing into your legs because they might not have been using, and it's going to help you when you go from being horizontal to vertical as you run through T1. And it also gives you a little bit of a surge and might help with your positioning in the field. And the final point to remember, which is something that's quite easy to overlook, is sort of sighting the finish or working out what the finish looks like, because we spend so much time looking at all the buoys. You get to that final buoy, and I've done it in a race, but suddenly I'm like, oh no, what's the finish actually look like? It might have a flag. Sometimes it can be quite inconspicuous, so maybe try and notice something on the land, because it's when you're going to be getting tired, and that's when you really want something that's obvious to look at.
I definitely agree with that. It takes a lot of stress out at the moment if you know what it looks like and what to expect. Well, some of these points here today, hopefully you can take on board, but others you may actually even want to just note down because they are so important, particularly that researching and getting to know what the course is like and where you'll position yourself for the swim start, because that can massively impact on the race and also take away some of the nerves for you beforehand. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video. If so, please do give it a thumbs up, give it a like. Don't forget to follow us over on social media, and don't forget to subscribe just down below.